Welcome to new JavaScript project. In this project, we are going to learn how to fetch data from the API, how to display random data, how to display data based on specific keyword, and how to display single data. In this project, I will be using the MealDB API. In this, we are having all the links related to searching using keyword, searching random data, searching data using ID. So based on our requirement, we can use any of the link and we can give our dynamic variables. To build this simple project, I have used the idea from the MealDB. I will come to my demo project. Now when I click on this search button, without filling any meal data, I will be getting please enter values. You can give please enter meal name, please enter dish name, whatever error message you want, you can give. Now inside this, I'm just going to search here pizza. Click on search. Whatever data is getting matched in the API, that data will be displayed here. And I will get search result for pizza. And when I hover on this, I will be getting this dish name. Now I am just going to search for chicken. Search. Whatever data I am having related to chicken, all the images, everything will be displayed here. In this API, whatever content they have put inside their API, that data will be displayed here. You can see the keyword is getting matched to chicken, so all the data related to chicken will be displayed. I will come to this API. And here I am going to search chicken. You can see same images, whatever they are having, same images we are going to get as a result. Now if I just write here sauce, enter, you can see related to sauce, I will be getting the result. Now what happens if I am not having any data inside the API and I am just searching some random data? I will click on search. I will get this message, oops, no data found. Now, again I am going to search for chicken. Search, all the products related to chicken will be displayed. I am just going to click on this. You can see, single dish, whichever dish I have clicked, that image, dish name, what are the ingredients used in this and what are the instructions to make this dish. All this data directly we are getting from the API. We have not written any static code for this. Based on this IDs, whatever ID is present inside the API for this dish, we are going to extract that ID and using that ID, we are going to display all this data. Now I can just hover on this. As soon as I hover, I will be getting this styling part. When I click on this, that image, dish name, category name, ingredients and instructions. Based on your requirement, you can give any styling. But in this, we are just going to do simple styling. And we are going to learn the JavaScript topics which we are using in this project. This is all about our search button. Now when I click on this random button, random data will be fetched from the API and the data will be displayed here. Similarly, we have this dish name, we have category, we have this image, ingredients and instructions. Again, when I click on this random button, random data will be displayed. Again, when I click on this random data, randomly I am going to get the dishes. One by one, you can select any one of this. Either you can select by keyword or you can select the random dish and you can see your result. So in this complete project, we will be using this API and we are going to fetch the data from that API and we are going to display in our project. So this part will be divided into three sections: HTML, CSS and JavaScript. HTML we are going to see completely because without HTML, we won't be able to know what classes we are going to use and where this elements has to be displayed. And regarding CSS styling, it will be divided into two sections. First is normal CSS and second is CSS while implementing JavaScript. So CSS code I will be giving you in comment section. So if you really want to follow this, if you want to make this project, you can copy the CSS code and accordingly whatever stylings you want you can give, or you can copy the same stylings and you can paste in your code. But while copying the CSS styling, make sure you are giving the same classes. If you are giving different classes, accordingly you have to change all the stylings. And third section, we are going to implement complete JavaScript. We will see how to create random function, how to fetch data, how to display the data, how to get single meals, how to display ingredients. Everything we are going to see in JavaScript section. Before moving to next session, make sure to click the bell icon. So whenever I upload the project, you will be notified about the video and you can come and you can continue with the project. So make sure to copy CSS stylings and paste in your code. We are not going to focus much on CSS styling because in this project, we are going to learn everything about JavaScript, how the data is fetched from the API, how we can display the data, how to call functions, how to handle events, everything we are going to see in this project. So that's all for this section. Next session, we are going to start with our setup and HTML code.